I think it's safe to say that Chopin was not only one of the most popular composers who ever lived, but one of the most original, and the two very rarely go together. But with Chopin, that's par for the course. He was the very embodiment of paradox. He wrote some of the most romantic music ever written, but he hated romanticism. The only two composers whose music he really adored were Bach and Mozart. Probably the greatest single influence on his style was opera, yet he never even tried to write an opera of his own. In fact, he confined himself from the beginning of his career to what on the face of it is the least vocal of all instruments, a basically percussive contraption in which every note starts at its loudest and then fades willy-nilly. The fact is that the piano is really a box of tricks, and no sorcerer ever drew more magical illusions from it than Chopin. With Mozartian simplicity and economy, he became the first composer to reveal what's often been called the soul of the piano, a world of sound that Mozart himself probably never even dreamt of. When Arthur Rubinstein said that Chopin was the first composer who made the piano sing, he wasn't far wrong. By the time he wrote that, Chopin had been living in France for nearly half his life, and with music like that, he breathed new life into the French keyboard tradition, which had been in decline since the deaths of the two great Baroque pioneers, Couperin and Rameau. More than that, he paved the way for Debussy and Ravel in our own century. Without Chopin, they might have been very different composers. Debussy honored Chopin above all composers. In some ways, Chopin really was more French than the French, and in terms of the piano, he basically defined what French was. But his roots lay somewhere else altogether, and he never for a moment forgot it. His name was French because his father was French, but he was born in a little village 34 miles outside Warsaw in Poland. And it was in Poland, and more particularly...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.